Hello friends, here in this video, we will take a problem of a vertical plane which is immersed in water. Here we have a question. A rectangular plane surface is 2 meter wide and 3 meter deep. It is immersed vertically in water. Determine the total pressure and center of pressure on the plane when its upper edge is horizontal and coincides with the free surface of water. So this is the question which we have. Now whatever is given here, I will write that in the form of data first. So in the data, here it is given that a rectangular plane surface is immersed vertically in water. So first I'll draw a water body. Now this water body, inside this a rectangular surface is immersed which is 2 meter wide. So B is equal to 2 meter, that is the width, and 3 meter deep, so depth D is 3 meter. Now it is immersed vertically in water and the condition is given in the end that the upper edge is horizontal and coincides with the free surface of water. So here the rectangular plane, it is coinciding with water, the free surface of water. So like this the rectangular plate is kept. Now we have to find out the total pressure. Total pressure is nothing but hydrostatic force, and center of pressure means H star. That is, we have to find out a single point where this hydrostatic force acts. Now with these data available, let us try to get the solution for this problem. Solution, I'll write down, since area of the rectangle, it is given as B into D. B is 2 and D it is 3. So area comes out to be 6 meter square. Now after getting area, here we have to even locate the centroid. That is, since the height of the rectangular plate, this height is 3 meter. So centroid will be, or we can say center of gravity will be at exactly half of this. So this distance from the free surface of water, this is nothing but H bar, that is the location of centroid, or we can say center of gravity. Now this H bar would be half of 3. So I'll say that therefore H bar is equal to 3 by 2. So it is 1.5 meter. Next, since we know the centroid, I'll calculate moment of inertia about this horizontal axis. So I'll say that therefore moment of inertia, I, it is equal to, about horizontal it is BD cube by 12. B it is 2, D is 3. So my answer of I, it comes out to be 4.5 meter is to 4. Why we have calculated moment of inertia? Because it would be used in the formulas. Now I'll say that therefore hydrostatic force is given by, the formula is capital F is equal to rho g area into H bar. The formula of hydrostatic force. Now here this will be equal to, rho is the density of the fluid. Since here in the question it is mentioned that it is water, so the density of water is 1000. G is 9.81. Capital A, it is 6, that is the area. H bar is 1.5. So from this, if I calculate the hydrostatic force answer, it comes out to be 88.29 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. This is my answer, which I can say answer number 1. Now this much is the force which is acting on this rectangular plate. Now I want to find out where this force would be acting. For that we need center of pressure. So I'll say that therefore center of pressure is given by, the formula of center of pressure is H star is equal to Ig upon Ah bar plus H bar. Now I'll put the values here because I have all the values. This Ig is nothing but moment of inertia about the centroid. It was 4.5 plus divided by the area, it was 6. H bar, it was 1.5. So therefore H star value, if I calculate, it comes out to be 2 meters. This is my second answer. So now if I can show it on the diagram, H bar was 1.5. so below this centroid we have another point called as point P, that is the center of pressure, and its distance from the free surface, it is 2 meters. We have calculated. So at 2 meters distance from the free surface, at this location, the total force or hydrostatic force is acting, whose value we have calculated. So in this video, we have seen how to calculate total pressure and center of pressure.